Welcome to Just a Fan Podcast, episode 23. Yeah, 23. I'm your host, Jeremy, a.k.a. Skullcap. My co-host is unavailable because he accidentally hung up the phone, but his name is V-Man, the laid-back gamer. But then I have a special guest, my brother, Matt. Yeah, that's it. He has nothing fancy yet. He'll get it fixed. How you doing today?
I'm doing great.
That's awesome. Hey, look, he's calling back.
All right, what a loser.
What? He's the co-host. How is he a loser? V-Man, are you on? We're recording. Did you just put on your earpiece again?
Huh?
Do you have your earpiece on?
Yeah.
Take that off. It doesn't work. That's why you hung up on me.
Yeah, you hung up on me.
You're fired. Oh, you hung up on me.
You hung up on him, dude. You have
any idea? Well, okay, wait a minute. Okay. We are keeping it going. Since Vima's going to take this earpiece out, I want to know what happened at Wizard World, Matt.
All right, what happened at Wizard World that we actually we met Jason News. I saw Warhammer 40,000 Space Marines, and, I got...
Oh, my damn, you're so boring. What did you do? You went Friday. What did you do Friday?
I walked around and...
As a what? Come on, you gotta...
And Shadow Guard.
You can't just think of what you're doing. I actually want to be Kylo Ren. That'd be so cool.
That's gay.
You're anyway, gay.
Anyway,
Verge, are you there?
Yeah.
Hey, you know, Matt says there was a lot of Deadpools there. Are you, like, intimidated or you'll be okay with it?
Yeah, I should be okay.
Hey, Matt, were they, like, were they better than Virgil's or did he have the better one?
There were some good ones, you know. One said like Deadpool for 2016. There's
for the presidency.
Yeah, there's.
I'll vote couple for that. Man.
I did tell him that when he passed by. I was like, "I'll vote for you, buddy."
Yeah, we have that mask. We go.
No, I had it off.
Oh, okay.
I was at the 501st table.
Awesome.
But
I wonder if you'll join with them because you're so busy, right?
Well, I was going to submit my pictures. I haven't submitted my pictures.
You have to submit. Is that an application?
Yeah, you have
is to. Is there a fee yet to pay $500 just to join?
No.
They need money, damn it. They need money.
No, it's a free organization. You have to submit your costume.
Oh, to make sure it's correct, right?
Yeah.
And then what else? Don't get all seriously on me. What else? That was it? Just
it has to be 501st approved by the movie. It has to be actually accurate.
I like that because I'm well, what else went on over there? That's all you did though? You couldn't just go to
I walked around a lot.
Did the same lady say, "Hey, I saw you yesterday"?
That was on Friday. He was like, "Yeah, you get really tired of walking back and forth," and I said, "No." But what you need what I should have said what you need to do is mind your business. No. What I really said
But you should
was,
say behind the mask.
No, what I said was that, well, what you need, what I always do is I remember to breathe.
Yeah, I'm not laughing anymore because you already told me that thing. Hey, Verge, do you remember that thing you sent me from Facebook? For
yeah,
Dragon Ball Z? Okay, it says SSGS. What does the extra S stand for? It's supposed to be Super Saiyan God. What is this last one?
Yeah, I'm not sure what that stood for.
Oh, my damn. Anyway, here.
Where God are you?
You stop it. The question was, if you woke up as a Super Saiyan God, what would you do? I want to hear, Virgil, do you have that answer? Do you want Matt to answer that? Or do you want me to answer that?
I mean, you two could answer that first.
Do you want to answer that?
Kill everybody.
You would kill everybody just to be a god?
Why not?
Man, you're horrible. I guess I would have to stop you, so there you go. That's the first thing I would do. Stop my brother for being killing everybody. You're a murderer.
First thing I thought about was like, yeah, I could be Vegeta, or you could be Goku.
Yeah, but Vegeta has pride, and he kills for a reason. Well, you just want to murder like Frieza.
Goku's a little gay, so I'm going to go.
Hey, he's a kid. How dare you? He's a kid at heart with a human, with an adult body. Why is it gay for that? What, you want him to be a man and be an asshole? Is that what you want to be? You want to be Vegeta?
A little bit.
Well, yeah, everybody wants beef and cheese. You know, they had a thing. Like they had a thing on Facebook like where they were saying that when I was young, we all thought he was a dick, but then as we grow up, we understand him now.
Yeah,
it was so great. I love that character. All
right, what do you think? What do you think, Virgil?
Would you just lay in bed?
Bird.
This is what I got. Yeah. What was the answer? What was your answer? Oh my damn.
Yeah, nobody thought about it.
You sent it to me. Wow. Are you done?
No.
Well, I thought you were thinking about it.
Do you have an answer?
Well, you know what? Think about the answer for a second. Did you go to movies?
It's probably going
to
be at the end of the show.
That'd be great. Do you go to Movies and Candy? It's a new rental place out here.
Where's that at?
It's on Eastern and Horizon Ridge. It's a new place. Like, it's been there for a couple years. I go there, and I was telling him, like, what would you do in the zombie apocalypse? I told him if I have all the DVDs, and if I have a whole bunch of power, for a whole solid week, I would just watch every movie before the power goes out. And then deal with the zombies.
All you had to do is get a generator, you'd be fine.
For how long, though?
But those self-made generators that last a long time.
How long's a long time?
10 years.
Dude, so much DVDs I gotta watch. That'd be great.
You know, you got pornos, and then you got all these other things you gotta watch, you know. Italian movies, French movies.
Guess I'll
Spanish
watch
movies.
Tiffany again. Yes!
You're a bad girl, Tiffany! You're a bad girl!
Yeah, that's like your first week. After like 2 months, you're like, yeah, I'm a bad boy. Yeah, give it to me. Oh, okay, I'm done.
I'm supposed to be watching movies.
Yeah. It was a movie. It was an adventure comedy. Yeah. Did you get the answer yet?
Virgil?
I was thinking about porno. What do you say?
He'd be fighting crime or something like that.
Like right away?
Yeah.
Oh.
So you would be a superhero?
Super dude.
Yeah, I get it.
Yeah, it don't sound like you had confidence in that. Does that mean no? Hey, wait a minute. Me and Matt were talking earlier. We're going to talk about this again. Okay, you're a superhero. You're low in money. And the bad guy's trying to rob somebody. And he had 20 bucks. Would you take his wallet just to get money? Because you need to eat something. What would you do? Is that still evil? Or isn't that just payback for the guy what he's trying to do? What do you think about it?
Just
paint
back.
You'll paint.
Yeah, but Verge, aren't you actually kind of stooping to his level?
Not really.
Aha! I have somebody on my side.
I think that you don't need to steal the person's money. You just need to actually kick their ass.
But he was doing it. He took an old lady's $20, can't. And then
would take the old lady's $20?
No. He
I took it back. I took it back.
Well, since I saved your wallet, lady, can I get the $20?
Yeah, I'm working with tips.
That's not what I was talking about. I was saying, well, he had $20. He was trying to take her 50. I saved the 50, but I took his 20 because it was payback for karma. Took back what he was trying to take. So I took his money for just a payback.
You know, Virgil, we had this conversation for like 10 minutes.
We're doing it again because he's involved.
And already, it doesn't make any damn sense.
For a guy that wants to kill everybody as a Super Saiyan guy.
It's the easiest answer ever. I'm going to kill somebody. I don't need to like go ramble on and on about stealing someone's $5.
It's not stealing. I'm not paying them back. No, I'm paying them back with justice. And here's a little.
I'm rich. Now give me your money. First of all, I robbed a bank. It's mine now.
Okay, I wouldn't take that money. I would take he earned money from his other job that he had. He wants to take more money, so I take back the money that he took from the bank. But I take his money. Working where? If he didn't have any money, I wouldn't take any money. I'm not gonna take other people's money.
Hands, you know that, Virg?
No, it's not. I'm not taking his money. I'm taking his money. If he had $20. If it was the $20 that was taken from the lady, I'm not going to take that money. I'm giving it back because that's her money. But if he had money, tried taking it, I give that back. He had the $20. But
you don't know. You don't know if he took that money though or not.
But it was in his wallet.
No, wait. What did you say first?
Oh, he spoke.
I say, so you don't kill anybody, but you won't. But you draw the line that's stealing from somebody.
No,
I know. Is that weird?
It's weird, isn't it?
Fuck the 20, I'd kill you all!
I won't steal from you, but I'll kill you.
Yeah, right?
That's it, yeah.
He's like the triple punisher.
I am. I want your damn money. It's fiat currency! It's not worth anything!
That's what he was doing. I'm telling you, you watch Shane from the season 2, he's like...
Yeah, no, he's rubbing his head, too. He always rubs his head...
He was rubbing his head because he shaved his head off. He shaved it off after a while. For some odd reason, when people go, like, they have hair, they're okay. When they go bald, they go insane. It's like a cliche for some
reason. Oh, yeah, like me. When I shave my head, it's usually like.
No, that's just you all the time.
Oh, that's true. I'm pissed.
Didn't you see any other celebrities there? You saw the guy from Guardians, right?
Yeah, passing by his booth. You have anything to drink?
No, I'm sorry. We can't drink on the podcast because we didn't bring nothing here.
Man.
Whose fault was that?
That guy's lame.
If you want, you can step out and come back, and then I can talk to him for a minute.
No, we'll do that.
You're coming back, right? No, you're coming back.
I'm coming back.
Come on. Come back. Hey, Virg, you have any other... No, don't put that on me. You have any questions?
I'll be right back. Because apparently people in this podcast can't really afford anything to drink.
We can barely afford that podcast itself. We have old video games to play. Hey, that's my garbage! I'm a hoarder, damn it! You gotta close all the way, door all the way. So, do you have anything from Facebook, or you didn't get nothing written down this week? I didn't get nothing written down for this, but I figure since Matt was on the pod, he was at Wizard World, he would like enlighten us on Wizard World. But all he does was walk around all day. You saw the Shadow Guard, remember that Shadow Guard from last year?
Yeah, I saw that.
Well, remember?
What was last year?
Yeah, but remember that overcoat he had?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, it was a black, whatever coat, the leather one. Well, this time he actually has padding. He has a lightsaber this time, because remember that sword we had to use so you guys can pose. So he has a lightsaber. He got it made from California by somebody, and he has padding on his boots. He has gloves. Dude, I have to keep helping him out. He has these wrist things. You'll see what I'm talking about when you come out here, because he's going to wear it again unless his Krampus outfit is done. He has these little wrist things goes around his wrist. I have to close that up. Did you get anything to drink? Where was my drink? Can you get a water for me? Hey, the guy would murder everybody as a god. He wouldn't steal one dime, and he wouldn't give me a damn drink. What the hell is this guy's problem? I'm racist. No, he's not.
Oh, I forget.
Disregard that remark. Disregard from the records.
Disregard the Toys R Us.
The Toys R Us?
No, disregard his acquiesce to his request.
Yeah, okay. Say it like you're saying it so fast, like the two cheeseburgers and fries. Like you say it so fast that nobody understands and they get it wrong.
That's how I do it when I order a cheeseburger.
Wait, do it right now. No, the double cheeseburger thing.
Can I have two double cheeseburgers, fries, and McNuggets?
Yeah, see? You couldn't even hear it was McNuggets. Luckily, I know you. That's so crazy.
Actually, I just heard McNuggets.
I heard McNuggets.
All right, Verge.
Did you hear what he said? He wants a McNugget. And he's racist.
You never said about the double cheeseburger.
Does that make you hungry?
Makes me hungry. Hey. Verge, to make you hungry?
Don't make out with the microphone. Oh. Wait until you get your own.
When did you get your own version?
Like, I can make out with my own. Hey, you know what? When I saw today, 10 Cloverfield Lane.
How was it?
It was the weirdest movie I ever saw. It's what you thought, but then at the end was a twist. But John Goodman was really good actor. It's like, you didn't know what he was going
for.
Yeah,
but John Goodman's always been a good actor.
I know, but that's why he was great in this movie.
I wanted to see Red State because I heard he was really good in that.
I thought it was on the Netflix. Oh, let me see.
I don't think I saw it.
Well, while we're still talking, we'll view Netflix. If I can get it. Let me take a look at that. Oh, he is good. He was a great... I think he was a
what
cop.
What do you think about that, Virgil?
He never saw Red State. He wouldn't have no thought on it. Do you have a thought on that? What?
Are you asleep?
Are you there?
Yeah, I haven't seen the movie.
Yeah, see? Told you.
What do you feel, Virgil?
I feel like a McNugget.
Tell me how you feel.
Red State. Where's the stupid... Is he not... Wait, did he... No, it's not on here. I don't think he heard you. Once again, nobody can understand you.
No, nobody can understand me? Alright. Probably because I'm from Chicago.
Don't worry, we don't have fans to understand.
Chicago.
What are you talking about? I think the people who are hard to understand is Brooklyn people from New York.
What up?
Hey, yo, wow. It's like, I'm like, what?
Hey,
yo, I have no idea what you're saying.
You should go to the next episode.
You gotta give it a minute.
Oh.
in the next episode of The Office, Pam really does not like Jim that way. And Jim just keeps going for it.
For like the next four seasons.
I thought it was three. Because two, didn't he get hit in three?
By the guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, in the face.
So that was
middle,
three.
I think it was the middle. Or it was four.
Oh, but then he made out with her in two, right? The end of two?
Yeah, I believe so.
You kissed Pam?
Yeah, it took that guy like two seasons to...
To figure it out because he was an idiot.
He's just a dumb white man.
So, hey, do you have any scenarios? Like I was giving you? Like
scenarios.
Well, we were talking about powers before or a Pokemon train. Hey, wait a minute. Are you interested in Pokemon? Like being a Pokemon trainer at all?
No.
Aw, damn.
I'm not gay.
You know what? He'd be Team Rocket.
I would be.
To protect the world from devastation. How is he protecting the world from devastation if they're doing it?
No, it's because they're the ones that they hired.
You know, I'm surprised the boss. Rocket. What?
Was that Team Rocket gay?
Gay?
Look at that
guy. Yeah, Jesse
surrender
and James.
Surrender now, we have to fight.
Meow, that's right! Oh man, that'd be great. We just need a girl here and then we could say the whole thing. Virgil, continue.
Continue what?
I think you would be the weirdest Team Rocket employee ever.
You'll be the one
all right,
that waits for his
this is
armor.
The boss.
You'll be the one waiting for his armor and says, it's done. And then don't think that a female's going to hit you in the face and then just like fly off.
Like the simplest thing you got to do is get Pokemon and all you can do is just shrug your shoulders. That's it.
I got it.
Did you understand?
You know,
Virgil, just go mop the floor. Just.
I got the Pokemon. What are you gonna do?
What Pokemon?
No, when he gets one, he's like, I got it. What are you gonna do? Because he's Team Rocket. He's like, I got your.
He's
Pokemon.
Supposed to give it to the boss.
What are you gonna do with that? You're supposed to give it to the boss. It's mine now. It's not yours. It's... You just keep it. That'd be fun.
I'm taking it back.
I'm taking it. It's mine. I'm taking this organization by storm.
I don't think you even know what to do with it. Do you know what to do with the organization?
Yeah.
What would you do?
What would you do?
I'm curious about that.
Well, what would you do?
No, we asked you. Because you right away say, oh, I know what to do. Like, you had confidence behind that. What would you do? Me? I wouldn't run Team Rocket. That's me. Now, what would you do?
I'm white, so it wouldn't happen.
Oh,
so
you're such a liar. You'd be the assistant.
True.
Of the boss.
True.
I'll help you, Virgil. You'll help him out? I'll help you, Virgil.
And I'll take over the world. That's a big one.
How would you do that? But aren't you protecting the world from devastation because you're Team Rocket? So if you're taking over the world, you're devastating the world.
Not really. It depends upon how you take over the world.
Well, I don't know. I'm asking him because I don't know
Didn't
how he's going to take,
take over the world.
We're not talking about religion. We're talking about Pokemon. That's fake. What?
I mean, you're the boss of the world, of course. You can protect the world being the boss.
You are the boss of Team Rocket. You're not the world yet. You got to take over the world. And I asked you, how are you going to take over the world?
Well, I'm going to the White House by killing the president.
There's no White House in a Pokemon world. What are you talking about? I think you have to go the Elite Four. Wait. So you'll have your Pikachu on your side and you'll go to the White House. Oh wait, we shouldn't be talking about that. You Today in American history, somebody is going to assassinate me with a Pikachu. That's it.
My fellow Americans, my deepest fears have come true. Pikachu is going to be down my pants and it's going to lightning strike me. So I must make sure that your rights have been taken away. Thank you.
We must take away this V-Man from Terminator. You do way better than I do, right? Damn.
I'm going to tell you this. Right here and now. Me, Obama, will protect you from freedoms.
From who?
From freedoms.
Freedoms?
Freedoms.
Freedoms? Oh, okay. Once again, I
from
couldn't understand you.
If it was Bush, you'd be like, my fellow Americans, I'm here today to save you from those terrorists.
Here's $600 from income tax. He did that. Didn't you get money from that? I swear, we got a second check in July, and we're like, oh, okay, we'll take it. But then, because that was the last thing he was done.
It was the estate tax, and that was supposed to be in effect for a very long time. And
for $600? That's how much it was.
I think it was. Because I got $600 plus like $1,000.
He only did that to buy whatever because he was done for 8 years. He was done.
I think so.
Wait a minute.
It's four.
This is Virgil's fault.
It's two terms. It's 4 years. Not 8 years. It's four. It's two terms. One term is four. The other term is four.
Altogether, 8 years.
Altogether is 8 years.
That's what I just said. For all eight. He was done. I didn't say terms. I said all 8 years. Interesting. I'm not that dumb.
About that?
I don't know. I'm getting there. I'm American. I'm a stupid. We're not smarter than the Japanese.
I'm a stupid. I'm a stupid.
This is what happened to the Power High School. Told me anything. He didn't teach me shit.
Special Ed.
Shut up. I'm a special. They called me special when I was in school. I didn't know what that meant, but I thought I was really special. But now, I'm just retarded.
My fellow Americans, I will make sure
this retarded is not in school ever again.
This retard is not going to be in school ever again. He's mad. Thank you.
I still want to know the answer of how you would take over the world.
I'm not a cook. Crap.
Damn right you're not a cook. You don't want to cook shit.
Microwave.
Nuke it.
Nuke it.
In the microwave.
I will save you from terrorists.
Do you listen to the AM whatever Tim listens to it? They sound so like the 1930s, like, hey, today's news. That's how he sounds like Obama with Trump. It's like things are going on and everything's out. I don't know how friendly of you, but
you're talking about Mike Savage?
I think that he sounds so like from back in the 30s.
Well, Michael Savage is he grew up in the old days of radio.
But it's funny. It's
he's perfect.
It sounds
for radio.
Like a time capsule.
I would rather listen to him than listen to Rush Limbaugh. And and Alex Jones.
I was kicking ass in that 3D blast game.
I don't give a fuck.
Hey, you better give a fuck. Hey, Virgil.
Hey.
Are you there?
Are you there, Virgil? Can you give us an answer? Why? Just why?
What part are you on in Daredevil?
You ask a question.
I'm asking a question. You weren't listening. What part of Daredevil are you on?
I guess it's the part of the blind, the guy that trained him came back.
Oh, the other blind guy?
In season one?
Yeah.
This is season one. I was watching season two. I'm done with season two. That was a great season. Look at that big ass pencil. I want that pencil for school. It was on the office. What was his name?
His name was
the human resource guy, the big guy that looked like he was always like slow. He had this huge ass pencil.
And then he got, and then afterwards he got married. I think it was like in season 6, season 7.
I thought married? That was the woman that got married. He didn't even get married. He was going to get married. Played, he was engaged. But he played in the marriage, remember? He was the band guy. Even though he's slow, he actually played great in the band.
Oh, yeah. He's the drums, wasn't he?
I thought he was, yeah.
Yeah. In a suit.
Yeah. Yeah, with that hat, too. Yeah, he never got married. The Alice or... The one with the glasses, the older lady.
Yeah.
The bigger one next to Dwight. She got married to that other guy who was, like, rich.
Oh, yeah, that was Bob Vance.
Yeah, he played there, and then he played, I think, to Pam and Jim,
We're never
going
to get to what's-his-name's answer, is it?
You don't remember the question.
I don't even remember the question. We gave him 2 questions.
We got him the White House because questions. He said he was going to bring a Pokemon to the White House for some odd reason.
My fellow Americans, these Pikachus are out of control.
They must be exterminated.
They need to be exterminated. ISIS cannot have control of these
Charizards. No, they have Charizards. No, Virgil has the Pikachu. They have the Charizards. Only thing Obama would... what's that Pokemon? Maybe a Bulbasaur. It's like... No. The weakest... No, he'll have a Ditto. It would have to, like, transform and Ditto everything. Remember Ditto?
Good.
Ditto. Don't you remember Ditto? He was like that blob.
I thought you said good. Good.
Good, take that. I don't want
him. That's what he said. I thought he went good.
No, a Slowbro. That's it.
Slowbro?
Slowbro. Remember, it's like the sloth of the whole Pokemon world?
I thought that was.
Slowbro was
I thought that was Snorlax.
No, no, that's just a sleeping, lazy Pokemon. That's Virgil. For Bush. Wait, how are you calling Virgil Snorlax? Damn, just because he's big doesn't mean he snores all day. You don't know that. Do you know him?
Do you?
What are you you're looking at a microphone, a speaker.
I want to know.
What?
He just...
not even big, but...
but he called you a Snorlax, basically saying you were lazy and sleep all day. Do you like that answer? Are you, like, really thinking about it? He's like...
I don't sleep that much.
How do I respond?
You don't sleep that much. That's not good.
Do you have a favorite Pokemon? We were talking about this. Because you know why
technically, I'm Snorlax because I sleep a lot.
Do you have a favorite Pokemon?
My favorite Pokemon was Alakazam and Mewtwo. And
you have to have one. I have Charizard. He has Pikachu.
You have Pikachu?
Your obvious favorite. What is your you can't live without, no matter what. What is your obvious favorite?
Alakazam, I like.
I agree with that. That's part of my 6.
Yeah.
My 6 crew.
But there was also, what did Sandshrew turn into?
Sandslash. Remember the spiky thing?
I like Sandslash.
Yeah, wasn't that a cool Pokemon? Yeah.
What else, Virgil? What else? What other Pokemon do you like?
Well, do you know why we're talking about this? 20 years ago, the first Game Boy Pokemon Red and Blue came out from Japan. What were we asking him?
I was asking what other Pokemon do you like?
What other Pokemon do you like? Testing. Is this on? Are you even there?
No.
Not really sure. I like Gyarados. For a water Pokemon.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. I should have named him because I liked him too.
Okay, yeah. But we said one.
I know. That was the one that actually popped in my head was Alakazam. But Gyarados I did really like.
Cypher.
Was it Blastoise?
Blastoise. Bulbasaur was the first age, but yeah. Not Ivysaur? What was the bigger one? Wasn't it Ivysaur? It was that. I don't like that Pokemon. It's so slow. I'm sorry. It was the from the evolved form of Ivysaur or whatever. It was the huge ass big one. You don't remember? It was one of the starter Pokemon.
Hey, let's get out of this, like, Pokemon.
No, but wait. I want to know something. What trainer would you be in a Pokemon world?
Not gay.
That's not gay. They're just happy. Oh. They're hobbits. Virgil said he would just be a trainer and just, you know, that's it. It would be like Ash. I said I was going to be a trainer and then a gym leader.
The quiet trainer?
Well, yeah, nobody would see him coming. Now, what would you be?
I would be the one that tried to catch them all. I'd be the guy trying to catch them all.
I think you'd be a Pokemon poacher. Yeah. Catch them all and then sell them away.
Yeah.
I thought about that. Yeah. Like, think about it. What's the difference? All the Pokemon are free. You catch them no matter what. But he's making money on the side. What's the difference? What's hurting the ecosystem? Nothing. Nothing. Nobody's getting hurt. He's just trying to make a couple dollars.
It's a Pokemon.
But don't you understand?
They don't exist.
We're in a fictional thing anyway. So come with me with this. I'm just saying, what's the big...
Actually, if you think about it, you feel like all the Pokemon doing stuff, you should not trying to kidnap you.
Isn't it? Like, one day, a Pokemon, like, same as you catching your Pikachu, he had a family, he had some kids, and then you caught him, and now they don't see their dad anymore.
Daddy, where are you?
Because you caught him and took off with him without even noticing them. But you know what? That's what the problem... What are you saying?
I said, do you have
I think that was the problem.
Yes.
Like, when they first started, I think how they were doing it was they want everybody to catch them all because they want to see the show. But then everybody got so technical over the years that, oh, Pokemon, it's wrong to own a Pokemon, and then it's this, and then you can't sell them because it's poaching. Oh, why do you do it to the Pokemon even though it's fake? Basically saying about real animals today. But wouldn't that be weird if they actually
What do you think about this first?
If they skinned them? Oh, that would be so horrible.
That would taste good.
So doesn't it kidnap because you know, like attack them first, then catch them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
To weaken them.
Yeah, but it's legal though.
So it's assault, kidnap, and he's like holding them hostage.
And then rape?
What? Nobody's talking about sex in this thing. He's 10 years old, he doesn't know about puberty yet.
You sure about that?
Yes, I'm sure. You know why? Because he had all those girls around him. He didn't care. He kept going with it. Because
he was gay.
With his Pikachu.
Like Ash.
It was like with an extra smile.
Like Ash, the criminal, he watched it.
Yeah, he should be locked up.
That'd be better, good guy.
Verge, we should be a Pikachu force. I mean, a Pokemon force.
Of what?
To arrest Ash.
That's what a ranger's for.
Oh.
And then there are some areas where you can't do any Pokemon catching. And there was an episode with the Genghis Khan. Genghis Khan! Remember that was so annoying. But there was an area where it's a preserve for Pokemon where they can't get caught at all. So there are some areas, but I'm just saying, what's the big difference? How is it poaching if you're catching them anyway for free? And this guy wants this other guy to catch a Pokemon for him for money. So what's the harm in that?
This makes no damn sense.
What are you talking about? We're talking cool stuff. So you guys are against me on this? Or am I the only one by myself where I would make money? I need to make some money. That's what I'm saying. I need some money.
I'm broke and poor.
Anybody seeing a Gyarados around? I need to make some damn money. Hey, I was wondering, they do not eat berries all the time, do they, on the show? I'm talking to you, Matt, too. Ooh. Any of you? You mean who?
I'm waiting for Virgil.
Because, like, you know, on the show, they only eat berries or Pokepuffs, but when you read the cards or the Pokemon, it says, oh, it's a predator towards this other Pokemon. I'm thinking, so it eats each other? I mean, I don't see it. It's so weird.
I eat some berries.
You know, wait, we're not laughing at you. Do you remember The Office, Virgil?
Yeah.
Do you remember the first season where they were talking about racism and he put cards on their foreheads to say who's who without, like, giving them a context of who they actually are? Like, show, like, the respect or something like that? He's not even a race. Martin Luther King Jr. is not a race. He's like, how am I black? That's what he said. How is he Asian? I don't know. When I first, I'm like laying in the living room when I was out here. I first saw this. I'm like, what the hell is that? I was just flipping out because what boss does that for their employees? He would get fired instantly. I remember when they almost closed down their branch, but then the other guy's like, oh, I'm going to Staples. So then they kept this guy going.
I heard you say something about somebody eating berries.
No, you watch Pokemon. You watch Pokemon at all, right? You know when they eat like stew or berries. Okay, where's the meat in all this? Are they eating Pokemon?
No.
Exactly. So, my thing is how they're getting any protein at all in that world. They're not. There's no protein in that world. How are they all fucking even thinner?
Why do you care?
I mean, here on Earth, we skin alive all these other fucking animals and eat them. Why won't they eat the Pokemon? I mean, eat a Charizard or something. That's my favorite Pokemon. I don't think they should eat a Charizard.
I don't think the Pokemon are cannibals. I don't think they
could
eat their own.
Okay, I don't... There's different types of Pokemon. They're not like... Okay, the word... It's like human... Well, it's animals.
Did he shut off his...
He didn't shut off his thing.
Why did they buzz?
No, that's just him.
Oh, okay.
I hope he didn't put his earpiece back in.
Did you put your earpiece back in?
Is that earpiece back in?
No. Huh?
So, what else is going on? I didn't have any material to write because I thought you were going to say everything out of the book. Because you, for some reason, you want to do 2 hours, but look at where I'm talking about Pokemon that we already talked about last podcast, and you're the one not talking about nothing.
Because there wasn't really much to talk about.
Then why did you want me to do 2 hours?
Why not?
Really? So we're going to sit here for 2 hours?
Yeah, and talk about
nothing. You want. Pokemon.
Yeah, why not?
Okay, here, I got a question for you. What is your favorite ship of Star Wars? Only Star Wars. Unless you want me to go further than that. Like your starship, if you would want to own one.
You know those, that battleship that got shot down by the, it's a Return of the Jedi.
Was it the pointy one?
It's that big ass blue one that's like really long.
Yeah, and then it went through a knife. Yeah,
because it got hit in this little one spot and you just see it going.
Wasn't it an Imperial?
No, it was an Imperial ship. Imperial ship where everybody's at, where Vader was at, where
I could imagine the guy who's sitting on there looking up like, holy shit, it's a ship! He gets burned alive!
He'd be like, what's that sound?
Oh man, that would freak me out if it came at me, or if you're on the ship at all and you're like, it's the Destiny! Okay, what's your favorite ship? What would you want to own? Wait, you would want to own that big ship with a crew? Okay. Does that mean you got a small... Never mind.
How dare you?
I don't know. Isn't it where big things of vehicles mean that we have small penises? Is that what that means?
But we're not going to go in this subject.
I know. I don't know why I went there. Here, my ship is the Millennium Falcon all the day long. The Kesseron and 12 Parsecs.
What's your ship, Frizzle?
What the fuck? Did you go to sleep on us?
Mine. Well, Death Star.
That is not a vehicle at all.
It moves.
Barely. He can't own that. Why not? The Empire's.
Why not, though? So that, what I had was an Imperial ship, and that's part of the Empire's.
But you can move that anywhere in light speed. You can't go in light speed with Death Star.
Yeah, but how did he...
Is he going to lock himself in one room while everybody's trying to get in there to get... Give us back our Death Star! Not in your life.
It's going so slow. It's going like really slow.
Can we do that? I want to do a YouTube thing. I want to do that. No, what are you doing?
It's gonna pause.
Why would you pause that?
I was gonna pause.
Wait, why would you do that?
Why not?
We're still recording.
And?
Why would you? What? Shut up. No, I'm saying like, could we do that? Like, have Virgil all dressed up. He's like, la la la, and he's all locked in his own room.
No, he starts going.
Hey, who was in there? It's me. Who's me? Virgil.
No.
What are you doing there?
V-Man,
aren't you supposed to be sweeping the floors?
I'm taking this over. I had enough of this shit. I'm going to do it myself.
Okay, I got a question. Okay, what's your reason why you want the Death Star? Because it's big and round?
No, you said any ship.
Okay, then what's your reason? Mine, because it looks cooler and it's fast. And I get a Chewbacca. What do you get?
Yeah, I get a Dr. Vader.
Damn, he wound up on me. Oh, yeah? I get a Han Solo. What else do you get?
He gets the Emperor.
Shouldn't he be the Emperor since he owns the thing?
No, he has the Emperor.
I am the Emperor.
The funniest thing ever.
That would be great. So wait, you have an Emperor, or wait, so are you the leader then? Because how are you up on the Emperor? It's like powerful and stuff.
Yeah, because I'm the leader.
Of the Emperor. Are you more powerful than the Emperor? No. So you're the dark side. Or whatever you are. You know, they were saying on YouTube that they never said anything about how bad the dark side is. They never mentioned it, they said. We assume that, dark side bad because Luke's on the light side of the Jedi or something like that. But they never mentioned it in the movie at all. We assumed. And then there were some other things. You know those spaceships? They never said what their names were in the movie, but they said it in the toys. We're almost done, but you wanted to go for 2 hours. Lucky for me, I'm a lazy ass, and we're going for 1 hour. How do you like that? Wait, are you having fun though? Wait, is he still talking? Wait, what?
Maybe the dark side to be good, but maybe I'll have some dark side
to
be
good. What?
Wait, say that again?
I said maybe all this kind of dark side is just misunderstood.
You know, I think they were saying that before. I don't know. They were saying something about that. They didn't say nothing about evil, but it was like, what did they say? They said something about they get cool stuff. They don't have to live in exile, but for some reason, Obi-Wan and Yoda had to live in exile, and they're Jedis.
Because it's like they failed. It's like they failed the Republic, that's why.
Oh, you're bringing in movies. I don't like that story.
If somebody blew up your ship, blew up your house, you'd be mad too, because they just blew up the guest bar, like...
Joke's on them, I don't have a house.
Yeah, they blew up the extra room.
The extra room.
Wasn't Luke the one that blew up the Death Star?
Yeah, in the first one.
And the second one
was Hondo.
Wasn't it kind of like Luke like a murderer?
He had to stop people, man. Wait, what?
I like his perspective. Like, isn't that murder? It is.
No.
I mean, like, what about all of...
Murder?
Stormtroopers, they didn't build the Death Star. Like, what about all those innocent workers that was like, they're building the Death Star?
Oh, yeah, the last one in 6?
Sounds like from Clerks. That movie where they had contractors.
He killed all those innocent workers.
Yeah, yeah, but I assume they're slave wage, or they're part of the place, and then they knew where they were getting themselves into. They knew, okay?
All right, all you gotta do is just give me a wrench. Oh, what the fuck?
Hey, yo, boss, I'm gonna come in late today. Oh, that's... That's them dying in part 3. That was the conversation. They die because Lando destroyed them.
All right, what we got to do is make sure the rocket is going to be up in the... What the fuck?
Hey, somebody's flying in here. Somebody's flying in here.
Wait, who is... Was that a death thing?
Now, to answer your question for me, Luke didn't enjoy killing, but he had to kill them. So really, he's not a murderer. He's a hero. Now, if he enjoyed it like Darth Vader or Kylo Ren, now that's a murder. Do we want to get into Han Solo again? Hey, wait a minute. Hey, Matt. When Kylo Ren killed Han Solo, do you believe he's dead?
Well, when you look at number 5...
No, we're talking about the first...
No, because it looks just like number 5.
Oh, when he falls
down? When he falls, Luke, you think he's going to die, but really, he's still alive. Technically, Han Solo could be alive, but if you actually looked at the interview... By,
stop bringing the real world with the fake world. Stop it.
I have to
understand that
he's done. He's done, and you gotta make sure
we discuss
that
he's
dead man, boss.
Wow, I mean, I did.
I mean, here we go. Because if he said he's coming back for another movie, then when that happens, you assume he's still alive, so he could just be saying that.
Did he say he's coming back for another movie?
No.
He said he's coming. Han Solo could still be alive.
Did Harrison Ford say he's coming back?
No, he said he's gonna come back, but Tom Donner will be. You assume that he's coming back for another movie that he didn't die.
If they were smart. Wait. How about this? If they were smart and they wanted to bring back Han Solo, because they changed the number 9 script already. They did some, because certain things that happened in the first movie people liked, so they changed it. Could you imagine the third movie? Like, they didn't say anything. They, no press. Nobody talked to Harrison Ford. They told him not to say anything until the movie came out, and then he shows up as a half robot. What about that? A cyborg Han Solo. What do you think?
That's
drop
dumb.
The mic. Hey, you're dumb.
That's dumb. Pick up the mic, because that's just...
What? The mic has been dropped. I'm sorry.
Pick it
back. No, the mic is dropped.
I'll pick it up.
No, get... No, put it back on the ground. Put it back on the ground.
Take it.
You scratched me. Like a savage.
You're the one that scratched me.
How did I... don't get nails. I bit them. I bit the nails.
But you're right.
I'm right.
You said you bit a nail?
I thought he said he's going to be black. No, I said I have bitten nails. He says I scratched him, and then I told him no, because I have nails that... I bite my nails. So now you're okay with the premise, because I told you that before, remember? When I told you that Han Solo is dead, then you didn't want to believe me, then I told you he could be in one of those air ducts, but then the planet explode, so I still think he's dead, but, you know, he could come back alive in part 3 of the trilogy of number 10. All right?
What's that? Probably, he survived this somehow. Huh? Luke fell off, and he survived.
What did you say?
And he had his head cut off.
He said he was alive during when he fell down the fuselage, right? Fuselage?
We're talking about Luke, right?
Yeah, Luke.
Yeah. I was going to say that. But Han Solo got stabbed near the heart. Like, dude, he's got stabbed. But then everything would stop in the blood because it was burned. So, I don't know. It's like, it goes back and forth. But the planet blew up. I'm sorry. His body's gone. I'm not a Han Solo hater, but... Now,
I mean, he's not... Until you officially see his body, you didn't see the body. How do you know?
I know, but... See, that's what I'm saying. They could save that for number 10 if they wanted to. But if not, that means he's dead, so he can go either way. Why did I bring
this up? But where was Luke at? Where was Luke the whole time? Like, we don't know where Luke was. Maybe he
was looking out into space in a mountain.
He was on an island mountain.
He was on a mountain.
How do you know?
What are you talking about? We saw the ending. Did you not see the ending, or did you walk out? This is bullshit. He killed Han Solo.
I know he didn't let him. You don't know if he was there the whole time. Kind of like
I don't mean to make fun of you right now, but I can imagine you like walking out after that. He's like, this is bullshit. He killed Han Solo, and you just walk out.
No, I'd be like this. Well, this is kind of bullshit.
No, you have to see higher. Hey, wait, could you get like really mad and say this is bullshit at the theater if you wanted to? Did you have a reason before, or you were okay with it? Were you, like, really shocked? Did your heart drop? Mine kind of did, because I was shocked. I expected, but then I didn't believe it, and then it happened.
Well, I wasn't really shocked, because he already said he was going to get killed, so...
I know, that's what spoiled it to me. It's like, he said that he wasn't going to do any movies, and I'm like, okay, maybe he'll walk away with this. I didn't realize he was going to die, but...
I think he was going to die.
But still...
It did not shock me.
I knew that
me.
Was his last movie, because he
just
said so.
Like, well, he... He basically broke his ankle for this film. He's suing the producers in China over the film because they did mishandling of his insurance.
Oh, wow. What did Hogan get in trouble for or something? Because he's winning money or something.
Anyway, Virgil, what were you saying?
No, wait. Didn't you see like something? He won a case, Hulk Hogan?
I didn't see that.
Oh.
What case was it?
I don't know. I was asking you.
I think it was the case for that porno video that with his friend Bubba.
That big guy? He did a porno? Who wants to see that? Not me. Would you see that, Virgil? I know you didn't hear me.
No.
Oh, you did hear me. I wouldn't see Bubba. Maybe his wife or daughter. Hey, maybe his daughter did. What is his daughter doing? Isn't he supposed to be? Isn't she supposed to be a singer by now?
I don't fucking know.
You want to say anything else, both of you guys? We're almost there.
What? That's why I was thinking about that Hulk Hogan porn tape I was telling you.
We were talking about, he was talking, wait a minute, he was talking about the insurance and Harrison Ford, and then it just reminded me, because I saw on Twitter that Hulk Hogan won a case for so much money.
Yeah, he just talks about porn on the Blue Virgil.
He talked about weird. It, I didn't know, hey, screw you, you knew what it was, I didn't know.
He was like, Hulk Hogan porn.
He answered me, I asked him, it wasn't me.
But you're the one that brought it up.
I brought it up. I wanted to know what he won for what. I thought he, it was like something stupid, and it was. It was something stupid that I didn't know, but you knew. You knew. You knew he was in porn. You knew he saw his dick. You knew it. You saw the Hulksters. Hulk.
What did he say?
I think he, wow, you know what he said?
Hey,
wait a minute. Do you guys watch At Midnight at all? A comedy show on Comedy Central?
Porn at midnight?
No. Do you ever watch At Midnight, Virgil?
No.
I didn't. There was a thing on that they showed that he was in court, and he says that his name is Terry, right? Terry Hogan?
Terry Bollea.
Okay, he says, he puts him on, he says, well,
10 minutes
left. Myself, I don't have a big dick, but Hogan, Hulk Hogan, he has a big dick. And he's the same person. It's like, what? How does that make any sense, the way how he said that? Wait a minute, are you leaving?
10 minutes.
Why? Aren't you enjoying yourself?
Yes.
Then why are you leaving?
Because we're doing this for an hour.
You have what?
We aren't doing this for an hour.
We were doing this for an hour?
We were just doing this for an hour.
Yeah, I know, but we're having fun. All
right.
Now, before we go soon, are you... Can you move it from the mic? It's like you're going to make out with it. Are you going to, like, do this again with us?
Yeah, when I get a mic.
Yeah, I want you to get a mic. When are we going to buy that mic? Oh, come on. When are we going to buy the mic?
Probably next paycheck.
When's your next paycheck?
Yeah, in April.
Why is it in April? Because mine's next week.
I already paid.
Okay, yours came Friday, right? Then it's in 2 weeks. That's not April.
No, it's 2 weeks because I'm doing my 2 week vacation. It's the next.
It is April.
It's the next 2 weeks.
It's April Fool's. Oh, Aunt Debbie's coming out. Did you know that?
I don't care.
She won't stay here, but she's coming out.
It'll be the, for 2 weeks. I think it'll be the, I don't know what my, next page
is. No, I was just looking, wait, the phone's right there. I was looking for my phone, it's right there.
Yeah, you said you dated someone else?
Who am I dating? I'm not dating anybody.
No.
Are you dating somebody?
And not at the moment, but I'm talking about it.
Who are you talking to?
The wall.
Here's a cut on the wall. I'm talking to this man right here. Hey, sweet cheeks, what's up?
The wall.
There's a hole somewhere because he kept humping it.
You're talking to
me. I'm talking to your hair. Okay, but we gotta get you a mic and then that one thing, right? You gotta show me what that is so I can go buy it. And then you'll guarantee it'll work, right?
I hope so.
Is that the girl from, was it the food place? Or was it toys? Or was it the back? Or was it the front? Was it the cashier? He talks to everybody. Oh, we're not going to say where he works. We're not saying it because we're not allowed to shut him. All right, wait, what'd you say? What
did you say? You was in the Marvel Universe, who would you be?
Who would I be?
Hobbity Hooby Whitey.
Wait, we were asking who you were talking to, and now you're going on who? What Marvel character I want to be? Oh, wait.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. I got a better one. I forgot about this. Here's a better one. Which X-Men? Okay, you know the whole X-Men crew. You remember X-Men, right, Matt? All right. Out of two powers. Oh, no. You have three powers of any X-Men. Which three powers would you have?
This is the last 5 minutes, so you better figure it out.
Actually, it's 8, but don't worry. We'll be fine. Now, do you have an answer? Because I have an answer. I don't know if Matt has an answer.
What's the answer?
You have three powers out of any X-Men. Evil or good. It has to be X-Men. It can't be like... I don't know who else. But do you have the three, or do you want me to say it?
But doesn't Deadpool cuff because he's actually, he was an X-Men?
Yeah, but, you know what, I'll allow it because they were...
He's an anti-hero.
Part of the X-Men universe. He is part X-Men because he went to that mansion, remember?
Doesn't make any damn sense.
It makes sense. Alright, you want me to say it, or you want me to say it first?
Yeah, you go first.
Alright, I have the three perfect powers out of two people. Do you remember, okay, Quicksilver, because I want to go as fast as the man of speed of light, like Sonic the Hedgehog, because I like Sonic. And remember Jean Grey? She has telekinesis. Oh, what's that other one? The mind one. Telepathic, right? Isn't that what that's called?
I hope so.
Isn't that what it's called?
I think so.
Okay, the one that controls and hears minds, the one that can move things with her mind, and super speed. Bingo, I am invincible.
What I would get is Wolverine's claws,
no,
bending metal.
No, you have to have... If you're getting Wolverine, automatically you're going to get his healing factor, too. So you'll have his claws and his healing factor. So that's one. Go ahead. I am the dork of the fan. All right, go ahead.
All right. Bending metal.
What do you mean bending metal?
Magneto.
You mean
Magneto.
I know it's Magneto, but it's not bending metal. It's doing metal. Magnetism. That's it.
All right, magnetism.
So you're going to bend yourself?
Yeah, why not?
Oh, I feel a little kinky today. Oh, I just got myself bent. Oh, man, forget a chiropractor. I can do it all day on myself.
And the weather.
You don't remember Storm? It's kind of easy. Her name is Storm out of weather. The one that's the weather.
The one that's the weather.
The one that does lightning and, what was it, snow and maybe a flood. Yeah. Oh, it was rain, yeah. And maybe a little wind, and then has some eyeballs that you don't even see the temples. So.
What's yours, Virgil?
Well, I never thought about it before, but maybe Deadpool.
It's probably Wolverine's shield tractor.
Wait, who?
Tractor?
Wolverine.
No, I heard that. What was the other one? You said a Velociraptor?
Yeah, I said a Wolverine's human factor.
Oh, there he goes. Okay.
I think a tractor.
I don't know. I know.
I got tractor. You got Velociraptor.
Because it's just the way how you said. You said Wolverine, and that I didn't hear healing factor. Okay, you got the healing, so you got the claws. The government took you, so you got the metal claws. So okay, that's all one. What's the next one? You got two more.
Also
have
Gambit's power.
Oh yeah. But what happens if you get frustrated and you might blow up the mop or the controller? That's the only problem. We're almost done to one.
3 minutes.
Okay, what else?
And also Cyclops power.
You wanna deal with that? Why not
Well, he wants to have shades inside and out, so.
So you wanna see red all the time?
But why not see.
Wait a minute, I don't know why I'm back talking. So, okay. So, I want super speed, telekinesis, and mind control. Matt wants Wolverine, the weather one, and then the metal one, bending metal. And then you want Wolverine. Oh my damn, I forgot already. I was trying to remember what he had.
Cyclops.
And
I believe.
Oh yeah, it was Gambit.
Gambit.
Man, he's going to be an explosive guy from his eyes and his hands. You couldn't even touch a woman if you wanted to. I'm sorry.
Yeah, he'd probably kill her.
Can I see your eyes? Ah! Don't touch! Do you know Grandma does not want to go see the new X-Men movie because it's devil worship and it's about God and everything?
2 minutes. That's her decision.
I know, but we had that, not an argument, but we had a thing that's X-Men. He's a mutant. He's not a god.
It's a fictional movie.
I told her that! And she
knows. How about his tittle legs? Instead of Cyclops' power, I have Rogue's power.
Who?
Rogue's power.
You.
So when you touch somebody, they just.
So you don't want to touch anybody or kiss anybody or have sex with anybody. Is that what you want?
Yeah.
But I'm still absorb people's powers.
For a. You know what the one defect that I found out about that power? She absorbs the power for a little time, but the mind. They have. You're not rushing me. It's not over yet. It has another extra 4 minutes. See, she absorbs their mind, and that's for life. So you're going to have so many minds in your brain, no matter what. But you only deal with the one power for so long. Unless you attach yourself so long, you might absorb it forever, but you don't know.
Knowledge.
So actually, I have unlimited powers. But I have more than just three powers.
But you have to touch somebody to do.